Yo, what's up guys, I'm Yannick from the Producer School, and in this video I'm going to show you how to pitch, form and shift and manipulate your vocals using the plugin Little Alt Boy by Soundtoys. If you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe so you never miss any new video from us, and without further ado, let's get straight into this. But before we start, this video was sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes covering dozens of creative arts like music, production, design and more. Whether you want to fuel your creativity or learn new things, Skillshare is the perfect place for you to keep improving. There is an amazing amount of content available on Skillshare for music production and recording, and a lot of the courses are given by professionals in the industry. The good thing about Skillshare is that it's incredibly affordable in comparison with other courses. An annual subscription is less than $10 a month. And another amazing thing to tell you is that because Skillshare is sponsoring this video, you can sign up with the link in the description and get a 2-month trial for free. For this tutorial, I will be using a vocal from our newest pack True Vocals, which has a lot of cool acapellas in there, which are royalty free. I'm using this one.
Don't care about anything.
And I'm going to open up a plugin called Little Alto Boy, which has a lot of cool functions but isn't that complicated. I will just go over every button in this plugin and show you what it does and how you can use them to edit your vocals. The plugin has three sections. One is for pitch and form and shifting, the second one is the mode you want to use, and then the last one is some distortion and the mix. Let's start off with this first section, which is the pitch and the formant. And the pitch button actually speaks for itself, because with this knob you can pitch up or pitch down the vocal.
We don't care about anything.
As you can hear, this pitch is different from the pitcher in FL Studio, because when I put it 12 semitones up over here, it sounds like this. And it sounds much more like a chipmunk, and I really don't like that. But this pitch knob is a lot better actually. You can also pitch it down like this.
We don't care about anything.
Then we have this knob over here, which is for formant shifting. And formant shifting is almost the same as pitching. But the good thing about formant shifting is that it doesn't actually change up the pitch. So you don't have to change the key of your track, but you can use the formant shifting instead, which makes a vocal sound like this.
We don't care about anything.
Or this.
We don't care about anything.
And what's also really dope to do with this knob is to automate the formant, so you get a kind of effect like this.
We don't care about anything.
Then this link button over here just links the two knobs together. So when the pitch goes 12 up, the formant goes the same. In the middle of this plugin, there's this mode box where you can choose which mode you want. Let's start off with quantize. The quantize function doesn't really do a big change to the sound, but it gives it a kind of auto-tune effect.
We don't care about anything.
And I think this is really dope to use in hip-hop tracks to have a slight auto-tune, but it also makes it sound more robotic. Speaking about robotic, there's also the last one called Robot, which makes the vocal stay on one note.
We don't care about anything. We don't care about anything.
Now for the last section, which is the drive and the mix, I'm going to use another acapella I found on Splice, which sounds like this.
Hey, yeah.
The distortion in Little Alto Boy is one of my favorites. It just gives it a really cool harsh effect like this.
Hey, yeah.
I regularly use this in my tracks when I have a vocal on top of my drop or with some vocal chops.
Hey, yeah.
And together with some formant shifting, you can get some really cool effects. Then last thing I'm going to show you is this mix knob, which can use to change the dry and wet signal of the sound. So if I want to be less distorted or a little bit less formant shifting, you can just slide down this knob. Then There are also a few dope presets like this one, number 5, which sounds like this.
We don't care about anything.
And this one adds a harmony to the sound. Let's check out another one, small chorus.
We don't care about anything.
Which is a chorus effect, maybe this one, low octave double.
We don't care about anything.
Instead of copying the vocal and putting it an octave down, this plugin does the work for you. I hope you now know how this plugin works. If you think I missed something about the Little Altboy plugin, make sure to drop a comment about that. And I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.